Every one of these little blobs is a galaxy roughly the size of our Milky Way. If you looked at one of these galaxies and measured its velocity, it would be moving away from you. But in the past, things were a lot denser. The gravitational pull of things was a lot stronger near the Big Bang. This is a crucially important insight because it helps us explain the second law of thermodynamics, that entropy increases in the universe or in some isolated bit of the universe. This insight that entropy increases is what's behind what we call the arrow of time, the difference between the past and the future. What this means is that the universe is like a box of gas that lasts forever. Entropy increases, but that's not something you have to worry about, the air in this room all gathering over one part of the room and suffocating us. It's very, very unlikely. Except, if they locked the doors and kept us here literally forever, that would happen. Everything that is allowed, every configuration that is allowed to be attained, would eventually be obtained. If you wait long enough, the random fluctuations of those molecules will occasionally bring them into lower entropy configurations. And then, of course, in the natural course of things, they will expand back. So it's not that entropy must always increase, you can get fluctuations into lower entropy, more organized situations. Remember, life itself depends on the arrow of time. We would not be able to process information, metabolize, walk and talk if we lived in thermal equilibrium. If you imagine an infinitely big universe with randomly bumping into each other particles, there will occasionally be small fluctuations in the lower entropy states and then they relax back. But there will also be large fluctuations. Occasionally you will make a planet, or a star, or a galaxy, or 100 billion galaxies. Maybe the Big Bang is not the beginning. An unbroken egg is a low entropy configuration, and yet when we open our refrigerator, we do not go, ha, how surprising to find this low entropy configuration in our refrigerator. That's because an egg is not a closed system. It comes out of a chicken. Maybe the universe comes out of a universal chicken. Maybe, naturally, through the growth of the laws of physics, there is something that gives rise to universes like ours in low entropy configurations. If that's true, it would happen more than once. We would be part of a much bigger multiverse. We now know enough about the future of the universe to say a lot more. The stars around us will use up their nuclear fuel, they will stop burning, they will fall into black holes. But even black holes don't last forever. They will evaporate, and we will be left with nothing but empty space. However, since empty space gives off radiation, there's actually thermal fluctuations, and it cycles around all the different possible combinations of the degrees of freedom that exist in empty space. So even though the universe lasts forever, there's only a finite number of things that can possibly happen in the universe. They all happen over a period of time equal to 10 to the 10 to the 120 years.